Good afternoon, and welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to our Sky Factory 3 modded Minecraft Let's Play series. So I decided for this first week we'd go ahead and put a video out every other day to kind of get us started and jump right into the mod, and then we'll see from there what we want to do. As far as the time frame and the timing and everything for the videos, since last episode, I have completely restarted. I'm actually on a server right now. Reckless Conduct's on here. Jay Jones was on here earlier. And I know there's quite a few people that play on here. It is the Voxel Squad, their Sky Factory server. So I decided to switch on over to here, and we do a little bit of server-y stuff. so... that is why everything's a little bit different. I did rebuild out the mob farm. It is a little bit taller, so we do have Enderman spawning in there. And then I went ahead and planted out some crops. I've been really busy getting dirt and kind of expanding out, so we have a little bit of breathing room and moving room and everything. We've actually got quite a bit of dirt right now. I did get a couple loot bags here, so let's go ahead and open those. I decided I'd hold on to them and open them with you guys. We've got some leather pants, a wooden chest transporter, that's interesting, chance isohedron, and a yellow banner. Then we also have a bat bag that dropped from a bat. It says, paging Dr. Bat, paging Dr. Bat, is there a Dr. Bat in the room? And it has a spawn bat in it. Oops, come back. We'll just throw those into there. I mean, I guess we could put the banner, like, somewhere. Yeah, we'll put it right there. That's good. Okay. And this wooden chest transporter, does this... oh, it does. And it breaks. Cool. Okay, well, I wasted that, but it's... I think it's made out of wood, so it's not really a big deal. Do we want to pop this isohedron, maybe? Okay, we've got a little area here now. Just in case. I don't think these do anything super bad, but we'll see. So... disco ball achievement for opening a chance isohedron. What did we get? Nothing happened. Okay, well, that one I guess was a dud. That's okay. So anyways, today's episode, I want to start working. Well, I want to get a cobble gen up and going. Just a basic... oh, wait a second. Is this a diamond block? It is a block of diamond. Well, we can't mine it at the moment, but we do have a block of diamond. That's awesome. So we did actually get fairly lucky. So once we can mine that, we'll have, you know, 9 diamonds to sit on. So not bad. But anyways, I want to go ahead and get a cobble gen up and going. So, of course, we're going to need our bucket of water and our bucket of lava. I did get that cooked up. Actually, I've got plenty of dirt. We'll just make it out of dirt, and then we'll change it over to cobble, I think is what we'll do. I know you can do, like, crafting tables. If you don't have a lot of dirt, you can always do crafting tables, and those can't be burned, if I recall correctly. All right, we'll lay it out something like this, I think. I think this will be all right. Honestly, I'd rather be above it. Well, this is just temporary. We're going to get our first bit of cobblestone. And then we'll change it out. So we'll put our water right here, and then our lava, which of course it's going to break this, it's going to destroy this bucket initially, like after we, you know, after we use the lava. So we'll have to make a new bucket, but that's okay. I don't mind. Clay's easy enough to get. We may just wait and get iron. So, all right, but let's go ahead. We'll put our bucket of lava. We'll just put that right here for now. And it breaks the bucket, but that's okay. Why is that not... why are you not twerk? Okay. So anyway, now we can get some cobblestone. Like I said, we'll set it up a little bit better here in a minute. I just want to get it up and going first. And so now we've got plenty of cobble coming in. It does want to wash us away. Normally, I would be above it, ideally. Okay, so we used up all of our pickaxe now, and we've got 42 cobblestone. So, not bad. And I think what we'll do is we'll just build it out right over here, kind of behind where, where we had it for our actual long-term cobble gen. So, I'm going to go ahead and just build this. Actually, you know what? I want to build it with slabs. So anyway, we'll bring this out just a little bit with the slabs and kind of give us ourselves a little bit of a platform here. And what we'll do is let's set this. The slabs may not burn. I would think the lava would get them from that distance, but maybe they don't. Maybe they do. I don't know. I can't remember. I tend to just go cobble anytime I'm messing with lava. Cobble or dirt or crafting table, something like that. Doesn't burn. Or I think like the standard crafting tables do, but I think the crafting stations don't. So, but anyways, we'll just build it out like this, and that way what's going to happen is our cobble is going to get created here, and it's going to be about feet level with us. It's kind of how I want that to be. So, and then we'll just bring this around, and we'll set it up just like this. I'm going to put a slab here for the time being. We'll put our water right there, and then grab our lava. And we'll put it right there. So now that's going to flow down. It's going to be pretty much the same as we had it, but it's going to make cobble right there for us. And so next up, of course, we do have to get into the wonderful world of ore processing. Actually, I don't know why I'm doing it this way. I have no clue what I'm doing. And we're just going to lay this cobble out. We're going to break it down. So what we'll do is we'll just, of course, use vein miner to break all this stuff, and then do the same thing with the gravel. All right, and then a little trick that Kagan Foster told me about in the comments for the first video is you can actually take four sieves and place them together just like this, and it'll allow you to sieve four things at once. So it definitely speeds up the sieving process, especially initially before we have it automated and all that good stuff, by just putting four of these together and just running them four at a time. Of course, we could do compression and all that, but I don't feel as inclined to compress. And you'll notice if you only have two, it's going to split them as well. So far we've got lead, ore, copper, aluminum, nickel, iron. Very, very nice. And then what we can do is if we get this, say, this iron, we can turn it into iron ore chunks. And then with these iron ore chunks, we can smelt them. It doesn't look like you can actually make the blocks and place them with this. So, and then break them down with the hammer again and all that, but that's perfectly fine. I did make some mini charcoal, to get our smelting and everything underway and all that good stuff. The next thing that I want to do is let's go ahead and get ourselves a little bit of smooth stone. Actually, I think three pieces because I'm getting hungry and I was cooking baked potatoes and all that, but I don't want to have to do that anymore because it's a waste of coal. And there is a very, very good food that we can get initially with our current setup. So basically just if you have carrots, then you're good. You're good. Or you can plant melons or something like that. By the way, keep in mind that if you're trying to get those farms started, what you need is carrot seeds, potato seeds, wheat seeds, sugarcane seeds, stuff like that from sieving dirt. So luckily I had one of each. Whenever I got done sieving, I still have melons that I could plant. But I had one of each, and then I just kind of grew it from there, but anyways, since we have the stone pressure plate and this piece of smooth stone, we can put them together to get ourselves a juicer. And this block, absolutely wonderful. I always love to have this thing because we can actually juice carrots. And let's go ahead and get all of them for now because we've got a stack in here still. And you'll notice that this carrot juice gives you 2.5 hunger bars and saturation bars. So very, very good food for starting out. All right, and eventually after sieving for a little while, once you have four iron, the first thing that you're going to want to get yourself is going to be a new mesh. So we're going to get this iron stiffened mesh because if you look at things like, for example, redstone, and you look at how to get that, your mesh, Like, it shows iron stiffened mesh or diamond stiffened mesh. Now, diamond stiffened mesh does have a better chance to get redstone. It's 10% as opposed to 5%. So, really, we could grab that diamond block and be set. However, you'll also notice that you don't get the other resources from the diamond stiffened. So, you can really only get gold and glowstone and gunpowder and all of that. And right now we kind of need a good spread of things. So we're going to go with the standard iron for the time being. And I don't know if I'm going to go for the 4x for that. Maybe. We'll see how much iron we get and everything. But now we can start running our dust through this and at least having a chance to get the redstone that we need to move forward. But at a 5% chance, it is going to take a while because we actually need quite a bit of redstone. And, I mean, I haven't even got a single piece yet. I just ran 36 pieces through there and did not get a single piece of redstone. So it's pretty bad. Realistically, it's a really, really bad chance. So, fun times, right? Yeah. So I'm going to do a bit of ore gathering or resource gathering. This is going to take a while. I can already tell. It's going to take just a little while. Alright, welcome back. I ended up doing a lot of sieving and working with resources. And then I realized that we have tiny progressions in the pack. So, a little bit of change of plans. I was going to go into... why did I cook that? I didn't mean to cook it like that. Oh, man. I'm losing my mind, I think. I meant to get a piece of glass. But since we have tiny progressions, I was originally planning on moving into extra utilities, but it does require a lot of redstone, which of course requires a lot of cobblestone. So, I ended up getting 8 pieces of redstone, but you need a minimum of 29 to go into extra utilities. So I was like, okay. And I happened to look at cobblestone generators, and there is tiny progression in here. So in order to do this, we are going to need to get ourselves, first up, a bucket of water, which is fine. And we can turn this into fresh water to make our bucket go a little bit farther. So we only need one bucket. And then, let's see, I've got this crucible running. Okay, we've got enough lava. Now, because I want to keep that one, I'm running my crucible on that instead of the torch, because you get a 3x speed increase on it. And so now we can craft our cobblestone generator. Very, very nice. And we'll just set this up right here, I guess. That's fine. And let me make some kind of a storage. Thinking maybe a drawer. I don't guess there's a way right this second to get this automated, because it doesn't seem to want to send it to the drawer. So, but what you can do is you can right click this and it will give you cobblestone. So it does make our life quite a bit easier, honestly. I still think going with the standard cobble gen to get started, because you do need the 6 pieces of cobble, I do think it's worth it. And then moving into that as soon as you can. So, but anyways, now that we've got that, I want to get a bit more lava made, because I want to make some obsidian, because we're going to make another thing from tiny progressions. And I'll tell you what, one thing I do want to do is actually let's take this and let's go ahead and upgrade it. We've got the iron right now, so we might as well. And the initial upgrade, you're just going to surround it with iron to get your cobblestone generator tier 2. And so we'll set this one up right there. And now you'll notice it makes cobblestone a bit quicker. So definitely comes in handy. And that cobblestone generator will build up about a stack inside of itself. So anytime you need cobble, you can just run by, right click this, and you'll get a bunch. So it does really simplify things a lot for starting out and everything. Because I will say that to get 8 redstone, which I ended up making a diamond stiffened mesh, and because I made an iron pick and got that block of diamond out of there, and I made this diamond stiffened mesh, and even running a stack of dust through this, it's supposed to be like a 10% chance to get redstone. I got 3 from a stack, so the chances on those are absolutely horrendous. Trying to get your redstone stuff to get started, it is really, really bad. So just a heads up. But anyways, the first thing that we're going to want is, let's get ourselves just a stone barrel, just like that. And we'll go ahead and we'll put this, and what we'll do is we'll put our lava into this, and then if we just get ourselves a bucket of water, we can put it right there, and that's going to drop down. That's going to become obsidian for us. So very, very easy to get, and what we get out of it is so nice. I promise you, it's wonderful. There's a stack of cobble. We'll take it. And let's get a bit more of this up and going. Let's grab our next bucket. And we're going to need 3 pieces of obsidian to do this. So give me just a second. Let me get just a little bit of this made. Just going to take a second on that last bucket of lava. So I'll be back in just a moment. All right, so we got our last lava bucket here. And go ahead and do that. And actually, now that I think about it, I could just leave this here. It doesn't have to be moved. And then we could just dump our lava in there whenever we need it. And I'll tell you what, I am going to go ahead and throw a little bit more cobble in this so that we always have some lava being made and everything. I want to get ourselves a super pick. So basically, if you just take sticks, throw down some obsidian right there, you're going to get a party pickaxe. Super fast pickaxe, right click for a surprise, and it has mending. 4 attack speed, 13 attack damage, and 2561 durability on this thing. Absolutely amazing. And if we were to throw down some cobble, you'll notice that it breaks through that very, very quickly. And if you right click, it makes cake. So, definitely a nice pickaxe to get. Now you will notice that making cake, it does take a bit of the durability out. But it is still a very, very awesome pick, considering that cake's going to last you a while. And it has mending, so it will slowly repair itself as well. So, definitely comes in handy. And the nice thing about that pickaxe is, of course, in the very, very near future, we are going to have obsidian automated. So, moving forward with that is, always having one of these party pickaxes on hand is not going to be an issue. We're not even going to have to worry about the durability because obsidian's, nothing. But now we just have to do a lot of ore processing at this point. Is quite a bit that needs to be done as far as ores go, to really push us forward. And this thing, sadly, this compressed hammer does not break things with vein miner or excavation is the name of the mod now. So you have to break these one at a time. You'll notice that we already have almost 7 stacks of cobblestone, and that's just like passively. Whenever I run by this, I'll grab a stack, throw it in there, and everything. It is very, very handy for getting cobble. But anyways, I went ahead and broke down some blocks with this compressed hammer, and we've got some sand and gravel and dust, all that good stuff. So what I want to do next is let me actually grab. I'll tell you what, I'm just gonna make another one. I really don't want to move. Yeah, I'll go ahead and move one of those. So we'll do that. Let's set this one up like right here, I think. And then what we're gonna do is just make ourselves a bit of clay. All right, now that we've got all of our clay, let's go ahead and get all of our grout. I've actually got quite a bit of charcoal here. What I've been doing is making mini charcoals, but that'll cook up a stack. So I'm going to let that run for just a bit to get our grout made, and then we'll get our smeltery laid out, and at least kind of get our smeltery place down. We're not going to do a whole lot with it this episode, just because I know the episode's running a little bit long, or running, about wrapping up point. So I'll be back once that grout's smelted up. All right, so we've got our half stack of these seared bricks. So the first thing that I'm going to want is, let's go ahead and get ourselves just a few of these. I'm going to make a small smeltery, I think, to start with. And we'll set it up just like this, I think, for now. We'll expand it and we'll move it and all that good stuff down the road. Now that we have cobblestone, I will probably start building us out a little platform, kind of to live in and everything. Because, now slabs are a lot easier to get and blocks and everything. So we will probably start in the cobblestone. We'll go from the wood age to the cobblestone age, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. But let's go ahead and get ourselves a controller and a drain. And for right now, we'll put our controller like right here. I know it's kind of close to that, but that's okay. And we'll put our drain right here. And then we'll put our tank on that side. Let me actually get a little bit more cobble going in our crucible. And then let's go ahead and get a faucet and a tank. And then we'll go ahead and get a casting table. I know we still haven't even made the Tinker's Construct, like tables and stuff. We'll get into all that though. I promise. I haven't forgotten about them. It's just, I tend to like wait to do Tinkers until I get the smeltery. Just because I don't really care much for the, making things out of things that can be made out of the table, but we'll go ahead and add just a bit of lava to this, like 2 buckets. That's good. And what's nice is now that we have the smeltery, we can actually ore double. So ore doubling is possible once you get the smeltery. So, I could have held out, not really used like any iron really, other than the 4 that we need over there, and then doubled everything that I got. If you want to be more resource intelligent, you can definitely do that. I was more just like, meh, whatever. that tends to be my the way I do things. I'm sure you guys have noticed. But anyways, we'll go ahead and get our tinker's stuff, stencil table, part builder, and I guess for right now, we're just gonna set them up like right here. I promise we'll be moving away from the slab age very, very soon as well. Because I'm not a huge fan of, having slabs for, all the time kind of thing. But starting out in Sky Factory, I do like having the slabs because they definitely help. And we'll go ahead and get ourselves 2 of these pattern chests because I want 1 for the metal casts for the table. And then I want the other one for over here for our stencils. So there we go. We've got everything set up. And I believe if we add a crafting table or a crafting station to this right here, now we should be able to just tab through. It's a really, really nice feature that was added with TC. If you have all 5 of these, you can just select what part you want. So it definitely comes in handy. For example, basically it goes backwards. So we've got stencil table, pattern chest, part builders, tool station, and crafting station. But we'll go ahead and throw our patterns into here, into there. And then we can start making all of these. I'm going to make 1 of each, which I know I don't have enough patterns right this second. But I'll just kind of go down the list and I'll get all this stuff made and whatnot. And we actually have aluminum and copper here. So I could throw this stuff in. Honestly, I might tell you what I could do. I could go ahead and expand this so we could cook up 2 things at once. And there we go. We'll get that stuff cooking. And I think that should make us, I know it's going to be like an awkward amount, but I think that'll make us like 1 aluminum brass to get started. Something like that. Okay, well, we got 2.5, basically a little over a half ingots of aluminum brass. So we'll be able to make a couple molds to get started with Tinker's Constructs. But anyways, I do believe that I'm going to end this episode out here. I know it's about wrapping up point. I feel like we did get a bit done. We're moving forward. And now we can ore double, which will definitely help us out. Because iron is not terribly common, to say the least. You know, I probably should have waited to make this cobblestone generator tier 2 until I had the smeltery in place, or started the smeltery sooner. That could have been a thing, but really all I did was waste a little bit of iron. It's not a major issue. So now we've got cobblestone, everything. It's a little bit easier to get those resources now, because I don't have to mine up all the cobble and all that mess. So next episode, I figure we're probably going to make a hammer that has the ability to break stuff, just like the Ex Nihilo hammers would. And that way it'll definitely alleviate a lot of this grindy aspect. And then we'll probably begin maybe working on power. So what I want to do is get into power and then auto ore processing fairly quickly. And then I want to get into, once we have auto processing, I want to start getting into, it's basically magical crops. It's mystical agriculture. So it's basically magical crops, and we're going to start getting into that fairly quickly as well. So basically we just need something, these little crystals that you can get from sieving sand with an iron or diamond stiffened mesh. So I may try to get some of those together for next episode, and we might start diving into that just a little bit next episode. Basically just the infrastructure, the starting point, with the basic seeds and everything. So we'll see. We've got a bunch to get into. Also, really, really quickly, do we have... No, I need black dye. Okay, and feathers. Never mind. I was going to say we'll get a clipboard. Basically, that's the Bibliocraft clipboard, if you guys are familiar with it. So we can actually write things down, make ourselves a checklist of things that we're working on. I am planning on using that very, very heavily in this series. So, but anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, as always, be sure and hit that like button. And go ahead and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. And I hope you guys join me for next episode. So, like I said, it's kind of every other day thing for this series right this second, or for this week. So the next episode should be out on Friday. So, anyways, and then it'll probably fall. I'm not sure which time slot or where it's going to fall. I'll let you guys know, hopefully by Friday, where the normal time period for this is going to be. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you guys join me for next episode for more Sky Factory fun. So until next time, as always, do take care, stay safe, and I hope to see you guys next time.